A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 16th November, on the front page you have ArcelorMittal's takeover of SR cleared by Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court has accepted ArcelorMittal's offer to pay an aggregate 42,000 crore as an upfront amount to the second, to the secured financial creditors of bankrupt SR Steel. So SR Steel belongs to the Ruyas, and we have seen the entire case going on for a long time now. Ruyas actually declared they have gone bankrupt, and they said they couldn't repay the loans. And now later, when the bidding started, when the case was referred to National Company Law Tribunal and bidders came forth, ArcelorMittal was selected as the bidder. The Ruya brothers came back saying that we will buy SR Steel. So they're bidding higher than ArcelorMittal, but then if they have gone bankrupt, how can they bid and how would they pay was the question. And if they can pay now, why didn't they pay in the first place itself, the dues which they were there on them? So that is why ArcelorMittal is, its offer has now been accepted by Supreme Court. So this paves the way for ArcelorMittal to take over SR and enter the world's second biggest steel market. That is India. So ArcelorMittal, ArcelorMittal is from UK. Then this is Ministry of Home Affairs officials quizzed on Jammu and Kashmir situation. So senior Home Ministry officials were questioned by a parliamentary panel, and they were, this was Parliamentary Standing Committee on Home Affairs, which is chaired by senior Congress leader Anand Sharma. So when questioned on the situation in Jammu and Kashmir and on asking if they could travel to Kashmir Valley like members of European Parliament did recently, they did not give any commitment. So officials did not give any commitment. They were questioned on the situation in Jammu and Kashmir, especially the prolonged detention of political leaders there. Then below you have, this is, you can see floods in Venice in Italy. So city suffered the highest tide in 50 years, and Italy has declared a state of emergency. And this is report on household spending put on hold. So the government has decided to not to release households consumer expenditure survey results for 2017-18 due to data quality issues. So this unreleased survey has been suppressed because it showed that consumer demand has declined in 2017-18 for the first time in more than 40 years. So Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation has said that it is planning the next consumer expenditure survey in 2021-22 after data quality refinement in the survey process. So they're not releasing the data. On page 3 you have, odd even seems to have had no effect on pollution, Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court has said that Delhi government's odd even scheme seems to have not dented the intensity of air pollution in the capital. So this was bench of justices Arun Mishra and Deepak Gupta. They issued directions to the Delhi Pollution Control Board to check vehicular pollution and swoop down on vehicles, trucks and three-wheelers illegally running on polluting fuel. So Delhi government advocate actually submitted data showing that 5 to 12% reduction in pollution has taken place because of odd even scheme. So BJP government and its members had been adamant on pushing that the odd even scheme which has been implemented in Delhi has no effect on pollution and it should be scrapped. So Delhi government insists, our government insists that it will have its effect. So they have made an initiative, but now the case has reached before the Supreme Court, and Supreme Court is also questioning the odd even scheme. On page 8 you have, Kerala will not allow women to visit Sabarimala Shrine. So government has decided to wait for a final call by larger Supreme Court bench on review pleas. So though we had discussed yesterday, Supreme Court review plea has not stayed the order, but has referred the question on court's ruling in religious matters to a larger 7-judge bench, and then it will hear the review matters, which is going to take a long time. So Kerala government has decided that till that time they will wait. Women will not be allowed to visit the Sabarimala Shrine. And this is UP police detain ex-army doctor in mosque blast case. So an army doctor who left the service was picked up by UP police in connection with a bomb blast that rocked mosque in Balragi Patti near Kushinagar. So this is a person, Captain Alam. His grandfather is a prime accused in the case. On page 9, you have BHU to seek legal opinion on Sanskrit professor's appointment. So this is protests which are demanding transfer of the Muslim teacher here. So appointment of a Muslim man as an assistant professor in its Sanskrit faculty at BHU has resulted in protests, and some students are against this appointment, and it was said that the BHU would seek constitutional or legal opinion on the doubts regarding the BHU Act. So the university has reiterated its backing for the newly appointed assistant professor Firoz Khan. So, selection committee unanimously recommended his selection on the basis of prescribed guidelines of UGC and Government of India. But some students continue to protest. On the editorial page, the first editorial is 5-in-1. So this is regarding BRICS summit. So the BRICS countries need greater connectivity and more intergroup trade to get ahead is evident. So that is what this editorial speaks of. And second editorial is crossed wires. So this is regarding digitization. So for the next wave of growth through digitalization, telecom regulation must be fair. So how telecom sector is being affected? Bharti Airtel and Vodafone Idea have reported historic losses in the second quarter of the present fiscal. So this is because of even the Supreme Court ruling, which has affected them the way aggregate gross revenue is being demanded by the government. So if government makes such demands, and if it results in the sector being significantly affected, two major players in the sector being significantly affected. So if this is one time demand, but if the sector continues to function and is healthy, if the two companies continue to function and are healthy, they would regularly every year be paying dues to the government. So that aspect also has to be looked into, or if the government wants that those who are in the sector for long should die because of such huge demands of taxation being made on them, so they should close operations so that the newly introduced Reliance Jio gets a free ground to start off its operations, then it's another matter. But telecom regulation must be fair is what this editorial speaks of. The lead article, treating education as a public good. So this is regarding the recent national education policy document. So it says, despite its lacunae, it is a vast improvement over its earlier avatar. So new education policy 2019 is its recent draft has been published. And this is groping in the dark on the economy. So the government's ever-shifting policy stances show its lack of understanding when it comes to economic challenges. So the economy is suffering and government's action are not actually resulting in some relief for the economy. Then on Saturdays on op-ed page, you have ground zero coverage. So today it is betrayed by the bank. So this is regarding Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank. So the virtual collapse of the bank following grave financial irregularities has left thousands of depositors in distress. So the ongoing fight for justice is detailed out here. On page 13, you have Center drops plans to bring in changes to Forest Act of 1927. So the draft had noted giving a wide range of powers to forest officers. So this was also protested against. Forest officials were given powers to remove tribals from areas earmarked for conservation, and it allowed government to open any patch of forest it deemed fit for commercial plantations. So such controversial provisions were part of this amendment which was proposed, but now center has dropped the plan to bring in these changes. And this is US trade negotiators to visit Delhi for more talks. So this is regarding US trade representative visit to New Delhi. So after Mr. Goyal, Commerce Minister Mr. Piyush Goyal, he visited USA for a limited trade package, now US trade representative would be in India. So that was the time when Prime Minister Narendra Modi was there for Howdy Modi meet. So the trade talks will continue between India and US. Then on international page, you have this news regarding Sri Lankan elections, but the results are not out yet. So we'll wait for the results and then cover this news. And here you have again regarding Hong Kong protests. We have been doing it. This is Lithuania and Norway swap spies with Russia. So two Russians were sentenced in 2017 and two Lithuanians and Norwegians were convicted of espionage in Russia. So exchange of spies has been taken place here. Then on business page, you have the coverage regarding ArcelorMittal case itself. So here you can see this because banks have loaned out to this entity, SR Steel. So the banks have an exposure of about 50,000 crore to SR Steel. So if ArcelorMittal takes it over and repays, they would be having their profitability improving. So this is it. So recovery will directly go to profit and loss account of these banks. And this is again regarding top court extends 330-day limit for insolvency resolution. So Supreme Court said that current limit of 330 days restricts right to carry on business. So this limit on insolvency resolution has been extended by Supreme Court. So this is regarding ArcelorMittal case. You can see after 2 years battle, ArcelorMittal enters India. So debt recovery in SR Steel touches 85% versus average 53% in other cases. And finally, below here you have rules notified on bringing financial firms under IBC. So RBI will decide which companies will be taken up under these rules, is what the finance ministry stated. So framework for bringing systematically important financial service providers under insolvency and bankruptcy code will be decided upon. The rules will be formulated. So section 227 of insolvency and bankruptcy code enables central government to notify in consultation with financial sector regulators, financial service providers or categories of financial service providers for purpose of insolvency and liquidation proceedings that they can be included. So these rules will be notified. So this is there. Then the last page has sports related news. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashar.com. Thank you.